All right. Well, hey, good morning, everyone. Welcome to AccuLynx's monthly webinar series designed to give some ideas and maybe prompt some thoughts in your head that you can take back to your team. We do these webinars every so often to kind of share some of the ideas and concepts that we're seeing in the industry out there, share them with the contracting industry, and hopefully add some value to your day, give you some things to think about, some things to talk about. Hopefully, you'll get at least one action item or one thought idea you can take back to help your business during this call today. My name is Matt Morrison. I am one of the trainers here at AccuLynx. And again, thank you for hanging out with me today. I would say investing a little bit of time out of your day to learn a little bit about what's out there. Today, we're going to be discussing different ways that you can optimize your business right now, right? You're in the middle of summertime. A lot of people are busy, maybe busier than they will be in any other time of the year. And so you kind of stress test your business a little bit. You can kind of see what's working really well and maybe what's not working so well. And so hopefully we give you some ideas here to optimize your business and get some more out of your day. A little bit of housekeeping before we get started. We're using GoToWebinar here, of course, to host this call. I've got a bunch of people on the call, so I've muted everybody's microphone, so we don't get a lot of distracting background noises and feedback loops and all those kind of fun things. But if you do have any questions for me about anything that I say or show, or maybe something that you're interested in, hit me up in the chat box and let me know what's on your mind. There is a chat box there in that GoToWebinar panel. You hit me up there whenever you want, and we will help you out. I do have my assistant, or my coworker, really, she's not my assistant, my coworker, Michelle, on the call. So she might be typing in some answers to some of your questions if they're relatively easy to answer, or passing them on to me if it's something that we want to talk about on the call here. So throw them in the chat box. You'll be chatting with Michelle or talking with me. Either way, we'll get you an answer to your question here. All right, let's go ahead and jump on to the next slide here. So a little bit of background on AccuLynx. If you don't know who we are or what we do, I'd just like to make sure that no one's lost or confused by anything here. So AccuLynx is the leading business software for roofing contractors and one of the first that was made specifically for the space that we all operate in back about 10 years ago now, 10, 11 years ago, we started up the business. But we were the first all-in-one specifically designed for the roofing contracting business. And at this point, we're proud to say that we've got thousands of contractors across the country and even some into Canada that use AccuLynx every day. What we are is we are a CRM that is designed specifically to help you track everything that's going on, to track your production, to track your sales, to track your prospects and customers, and really just kind of see everything in one place, creating that really that true central source of truth that that seems like everybody is looking for in their business here. Our partners are your partners, right? A lot of the people out there that support us and understand some of the value that we bring to the contracting industry are the same ones that you guys use every day. So you may have seen our names in different brochures and materials from ABC Supply, Owens Corning, Certainty, some guys like that out there. So, we're out there in the same space that you are in. So let's go ahead and move on here. Kind of get past all of that. So let's talk about optimizing your business, right? Technology can really help support a lot of what you're doing in your business. But if you rely on a lot of separate applications and systems, while each one of them in their own little microcosm might do a pretty good job, it does make it difficult at the company level to pull everything into one place and really kind of get organized and see what's going on. So we're going to talk about some of the different ways that technology can help optimize your business, right? Optimizing it really requires taking a look at what's going on and trying to find ways to implement stuff that's going to bring everything together, help you be more efficient, with the end result being that you're going to save time not looking for files and folders and cross-referencing this app to that app. Eliminate or at least reduce the slowdowns and the bottlenecks that can come when only one person or only one application knows what's going on. So we can't move forward until we call Katie and find out what Katie knows about the story of the job. Trying to put everything into one place, eliminating the need or the or eliminating the slowdown of information. Of course, that reduces the need of reduces the potential for errors. There's always that potential, but the fewer times you're entering into information and looking for information, the more you've got things in one place, the more you've got things just kind of working together, you reduce the risk of errors being in there. And of course, all of that turns into more revenue, right? You spend more time generating business and less time just churning around paper and looking at spreadsheets and all that kind of good stuff. So really optimizing your business helps you focus on the big picture, increase your profits, and reduce the need to spend all of your time focusing on the small little details. So now really is the most important time to start optimizing your business, right? It is summertime, and in any year, that would be a busy time of year. There's been this little thing called a pandemic going on, and a lot of states and areas are opening up a little bit more, some more than others, but allowing you to get out there and get some more, to generate some more business. And some people that have needed work are now, you know, that you've kind of got this little backlog that has to get taken care of, right? So this can be the busiest time of year in any time of year, but especially now. Now, you need to be able to take on as much work as possible and manage that work, not lose the details, not get caught up in stuff. But this year also represents an opportunity to maybe pick up or make up for some of the revenue that you lost earlier in the year when you couldn't operate as well. But, you know, really the bottom line is waiting to make a positive impact is only going to slow down and wait, or make you wait for the benefits of those things, right? It's going to keep you from reaching your full potential. And I know some people might be hesitant, saying, well, it's summertime, you know, we're so busy. I know there's an old saying that I heard years ago that's always stuck with me, that says the best time to plant a tree was 15 years ago, and the second best time is today, right? This is the time of year when you are finding that your business is, you're stress testing it, right? If you've got a weakness, you know about it right now, because, you know, it's, but you're busting at the seams and you're seeing those areas where your business is maybe faltering and how you could improve upon it. So hopefully some of these ideas will be something you can take back and help your business grow. So first of all, think about trying to align your teams, right? You can see the stat on the page from Instapage about a lack of alignment, right? It impacts the outcome of the project, right? If you don't have teams on the same page, and what you have are basically teams in silos, right? Where one person is kind of living in their little world and the other department's living in their little world. And those silos exist because you don't have communication, or it's difficult to communicate between those different departments. And that could be, we don't have all the same documentation, we don't have the same notes, I don't have access to the same information, whether that be financial or production or sales or contracts or whatever. Having everything in a single shared system can really help bring your customer relationship management and your project management together to create more accountability and more visibility in your team. So as an example, right, you could have your production teams, see what's going on, or giving them the tools to kind of manage the schedules, to order materials. Your accounting team can see what the financial impact of various jobs are. Sharing information back and forth between different teams, even with your different crews, can help ensure that everybody's on the same page, and that, what the person over here said is given to what the person over here who needs to take action on those things are, right? A person in the field collects data, a person who's going to go install that work needs to know that data, right? It can also help you streamline the sales and the accounting process by processing everything in one place, even payments, right? If you can get payments processed into one place where you're putting the information in for payments, but it's also where all the information about the sale and the contract is, again, you're putting everything in one place and you have less reconciling and less comparing and contrasting and spreadsheets and cross-references and everything else that you've got to do to really truly get the picture of what's going on. In fact, if you can even process payments electronically, you can get access to your funds even faster, right? So that can improve cash flow and help you do more business as well. So let's move on here. The next one, think about standardizing your process, right? I have worked with companies, thousands of companies in the last 9 years almost now, 9 or 10 years. And, you know, so often what I hear is things like, oh, well, you know, Steve does it this way and George does it that way and Sue does it the other way. Well, because it works better for them. But what that usually means is that if you're the poor person in the office that is having to, you know, receive that information or act on that information, that means you don't have a process, a workflow. workflow. There's not a way that your company operates. If I were to come and join your team tomorrow, there would be no one standardized way that you could tell me you guys do business, because everybody kind of does things their own way because, well, it's easier for them. What we want to try to do is think about standardizing that process so that everybody in the company is doing things the same way, right? So, you know, first of all, define what your process is. Make it so that everyone kind of follows the same step. Everyone knows what to do, and one person could even pick up and help the other person out if they need to. So whether that be from the person who answers the phone and enters a lead all the way to the other end of a job of, you know, paying that last bill or collecting the last bill or check and paying that job out, every step of the workflow should be designed to kind of eliminate redundancies, to eliminate the need to go hunting and pecking for information all over the place, and instead just everyone goes to the same place to do things the same way. If anyone on the call has ever spent time in the military or the police force, fire department, those kinds of things, right, you know that there's that, what's drilled into you is the idea of everyone doing things the same way. Everyone uses the, you know, the same alphabet when they're talking on the radio, and everybody, you know, does thing, you know, does paperwork the same way. And what that does is that breeds efficiency, because now anybody can step in and help out. Now, standardization also includes bringing everything into one place, right? So that you can do that, right? So that you've got a standard process. Now let's bring everything into one place, right? So by integrating all of your information into one system, right, into one place, you start to save time. You reduce the human error or the potential for human error. If you're using other apps, right, like a lot of contractors use apps like Spotio or SalesRabbit for canvassing and things like that, you can bring those integrations in to put everything into one place. Maybe even in, you know, we, you know, in AccuLynx, we have stuff like that, but, you know, bringing everything into one place, think about integrations that can integrate the different things that you are, that you may be using out there. Same thing with your aerial diagrams. If you order measurements from, you know, Eagle View or someplace like that, pulling information in like that, you know, pulling all of that information in, consolidating everything into one place. And I can go on and on, but you get the idea here, right? And then lastly, of course, once everything's in one place, make sure your teams have access to the information that they need to do their jobs, right? So you standardize the process, you bring everything into one place, then you make sure that everybody has access to the information that they need so that they can do their jobs there. So that way you can see, you know, where a job is at any point in time, right? So not only do people have access to that, but when you put everything into one place from a management level, from an ownership level, you can now look into your business and see what's going on, ask questions of that database and get some answers back, right? Think about trying to automate some of your processes, especially your communications, right? If you find that you're always sending emails to people to let them know that their job is scheduled or welcome them to your company's, you know, when they sign a contract, maybe send them a welcome letter and give them some initial information, or when the job is done, sending a packet of information out or whatever it is. If you could automate some of those things, instead of spending countless hours copying and pasting or typing things in or responding to various things, trying to automate those things can really streamline your process. And it also creates a more consistent experience for your customer, right? So no matter who's sitting at that desk, no matter who's filling that position, your customers get a consistent experience. If you think about many of the big businesses that you interact with, you know, everyone talks about McDonald's, right? But, you know, like it or hate it, when you go to McDonald's, you're going to get a pretty consistent experience. That's one of the things that they do, right? You know, making sure that the customer knows what to expect when they come and they work with, or they ask you to work for, work for them, right? So automations can really help not only save time, but also improve the experience that your customer has when you're working with them. Now, how about this? We talked about it a slide ago, but you can leverage your company data, right? You've got this now, when you put everything in one place, you've now got a database that tells a whole lot of the story about your business. And, you know, some of us might go to different conferences, we might listen to different business coaches, we might read different books, we might watch a video online or whatever the case is. And all of a sudden our eyes are open to this new thing that we should be tracking, this new way we should be looking at our business, right? When you have everything in one place, you can now start to pull that information back out, right? You can start to pull the information out and ask questions. Maybe you want to know which city in your area is performing well, or which trade type has higher profit margins, or things like that, right? Being able to leverage that data is going to allow you to make more intelligent decisions about your business, right? if there's a shift in production, if you're starting to see that certain crews are consistently having, you know, go backs or punch out work where you got to go back, well, that might be a crew you need to talk with or even release from your ranks because they're, you know, they're bringing your business down, right? Maybe you want to run sales reports and see closing ratios and that kind of stuff, right? Running all the different reports you need to monitor your business, it can still be time consuming, but if you can set up like dashboards and put all of those things in one place, decide what's going to be important to you and put it right in front of your face, that can be a way to help you save some time and get those answers that you need quickly. And also, don't be afraid to share that information, right? You're pulling that information out. Talk to your different departments. If you're kind of doing a deep dive on production and whatever, then bring your production teams in and show them what you're seeing. Hey, this is what the numbers look like. You know, these trades are taking a long time, or this crew is having a lot of punch out work, or that salesperson has got a great closing percentage. Maybe we should have him come into the sales meeting and talk to the rest of the team about some of the things that they're doing, right? These are all examples of once you can pull that data in and look at it and track it, you can start to share that information with your team, right? So being able to, I just recently was in a conversation with somebody where they said some, you know, they took some words and some actions that I had taken, they threw them back to me in a different way. And I was able to look at that in a different light than what I had originally put out there, right? I didn't recognize some of the things until somebody packaged it up and sent it back to me and said, you know, hey, this was the result. And I was able to go, oh my goodness, I didn't even realize that, right? Because you get so caught up in your own little world that you don't always realize the bigger picture. And so being able to share those findings can help your team members make better decisions or change their actions if some of their things are maybe not returning the results that you want. So what kind of system allows you to do all of this? I mean, AccuLynx is a system that we have put together that specifically is designed to help optimize the business or the businesses that operate in the contracting space, right? It brings all of those different things together, helps you improve efficiency, sell smarter, knowing where to work or who's doing better work out there or whatever. Especially in this day and age, it helps you work from anywhere, right? Many of our contractors did not slow down during the lockdown orders that were in place back in the spring, right? They were able to still maintain their business, except people were working from their couch or their office or whatever it is, as opposed to some centralized location. They're able to keep up communications back and forth and with their customers and really collaborate together, right? Move back and forth together or work back and forth, sharing information and everyone, again, knowing what's going on, right? So those are some of the tools, some of the benefits that we've seen our customers get out of using a system like AccuLynx, especially in these times here, right? The bottom line is really AccuLynx helps you grow, right? It helps you take the assets that you've got and get more out of them or grow into new markets, new areas, whatever, without needing to increase a ton more assets or, you know, people, manpower, tools, and whatever. AccuLynx really helps you grow your business, right?